Hello, Schmozone. What's up, everyone? I'm Shake and Bake here at the Schmo Table, here with Rain Man and Divock, as always. And guys, it is March. And by March, I mean it's 2 weeks into March, which means it's time for March Madness to finally start and pick its ass up.
Yeah, it's time to start caring about college basketball.
Yeah.
That's what it's time for.
Divock, you are very firm on the stance that you do not care until right about now.
I used to love college basketball all the way through. And then at some point, I just figured out that the level of play went down so considerably that it just didn't matter to me anymore until the tournament. Because it's just a crapshoot, really is, more than it's ever been. I look at the teams. I look at the teams like 10 years ago, like those Illini teams, the UNC teams, UConn. These teams would beat any team out there right now, I think, by at least 20 points.
Well, they have the continuity.
Exactly.
Well, exactly. I believe we've said on this program more than once that the last great college basketball team in recent memory was the 2012-2013 Louisville national champion team.
Yeah.
And
yeah, they were really good.
Since then, you know, you're right. I am significantly unimpressed by, you know, we had an 8-9 matchup the year after with Kentucky playing UConn in the national title, pretty much.
But it was I remember that UConn Butler game, which was just the worst championship ever.
I fell asleep. That's the only national title sporting event I've watched that I fell asleep in. Just
horrible.
Ass on the ass up on the couch.
Horrible.
Awful. Awful game.
And then, it's still March Madness. It's still a ton of fun.
We have Divock's crispy, crunchy insights here that he's raring to share with us.
Yeah, I'm raring.
Divock, lay some knowledge on us.
Okay. My favorite. So I don't try to get too analytical with the whole March Madness because in the end, it's all luck. My mom was the only one I knew who picked Villanova to win the championship last year. And she knows nothing about sports whatsoever and didn't go to Villanova. She liked the name. So basically, I try not to get too analytical, but this one is my favorite thing. The first four games. So the winners of the first four, one of those teams has won their first round game every single year. Four of those teams have gone to the Sweet 16 or farther. So we had VCU in 2011 go to the Final Four. You had LaSalle go to the Elite Eight. You had South Florida went to the Sweet 16 one year. Tennessee went to the Elite Eight one year. And then I think it was like Wichita State and Dayton were the other two teams that both won their first game. So basically that spells bad news for SMU and Cincinnati. One of those teams, based on history, one of those teams is going to go down. And I really, really, really like for whatever reason, that last team in always plays with like a chip on their shoulder. And VCU was that last team in. I remember George Mason, the year they went to the Final Four, was the last team in. None of the experts thought they should have made it. And so I'm looking at USC to beat Providence. They got that Florida Gulf Coast guy, Enfield, as their head coach. He's got some tourney success in the past. I'm looking at them to beat a very overrated SMU team. Baylor is complete shit every year. So I'll put them to beat Baylor, and I hate Duke, so I'll put them to beat Duke. So that's my insight right there.
Even with how hot you are, SMU finished their season, and Bearcats, my Cincinnati Bearcats, my hometown Bearcats, did not. See, I'm thinking if I'm going to pick one of those teams to go through, I'd be picking whoever's playing UC because UC's offense is just as bad as my Alabama Crimson Tide's offense. And, and that's some shit offense. I'll tell you what, guys.
Yeah. My thing is, I think
SMU is one of those teams that is like sneaky good to be built to win in this tournament.
Everybody thinks that. You know how many
That's true, too. That's a hot pick right now.
You know how many tournament teams SMU beat this year? Besides Cincinnati.
Not many.
Zero. Yeah. Not a single one.
Ooh,
that American Conference is a complete shithole.
It's atrocious.
It's two teams.
It's two teams.
We know it's two teams.
And yeah, you'll see USC already beat SMU this year, by the way.
Yes, they did. Okay.
If you're looking to pick a team to make a run, one of those double digit seeds, I always go for the winner of one of these games right here. And I won't take a Bruce Weber team in Kansas State. And Wake Forest, I know nothing about, but
they've got a legit NBA player carrying the squad. That's what you need to know about Wake Forest.
Okay. Well, they got to win. They have
Danny Manning as their coach. Former Kansas
Danny
star.
Okay, there you go. Danny the Miracles. There you go. Maybe that's the pick right there. But no, I'll be riding. I think USC will take down Providence tomorrow, and then I'll be riding them to the Elite Eight.
Okay.
So that's my number one insight. You want another one?
How many are we going down there? Are we talking about like 67 or 3 or 4?
My insights?
Yeah.
I could go for 57, but I'll go for 2.
Okay.
So when picking –
more weeks in the tournament to come.
There are. So when picking your 12, 13, 14 upsets, everyone likes to pick those. Mm-hmm. Last year, the five lowest spread games for those 12, 13, 14 seeds, four of them won. So when you're looking to pick those games, don't go for the double-digit underdogs. You need to look at – so this year, Princeton's only a 7-point underdog. Middle Tennessee's favored as a 12 seed.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's strange, but okay. And then Iowa State is a 5.5-point favorite. And then Virginia is a 7.5-point favorite. And then the final one is Vermont is an 8.5-point underdog against Purdue, which I really like. So that's my a little insight there. I'll probably pick 3 of those to be winners. So
I got to say, as going through the Ivy League, watching Princeton play, I would not say that they were going to beat Notre Dame. Not at all. I would say that would be the one. I would say Notre Dame's a pretty solid lock. I'd say Middle Tennessee, I actually had them for a while. Virginia UNC Wilmington is a really interesting one. I think UNC Wilmington could really pull off the upset. I think Iowa State is pretty much, you know, running in pretty hot. I don't see them losing to Nevada. No,
they don't have Hoiberg anymore, so they're good.
True,
they're golden.
Yeah.
So, but no, I was thinking Wilmington originally, but there's something about that Ivy League. I go with past success, and that conference has had so much success in the tournament. What? They have.
I know.
What's so funny about that? Cornell, Harvard, Yale. Every year, it seems like an Ivy League team's pulling off an upset.
I know.
So why not stick with it?
Yeah. I just see ND beating them. Like, Princeton's game is watching an Ivy League tournament. I don't see them beating ND. They could.
I actually watched it.
I don't see it happening. But it could happen. I think Middle Tennessee and UNC Wilmington are the best picks out of the 5-12 matchups. And the 5-12 matchups, there have been numerous upsets in every single year. So I think that those are the two strongest. The other two could do it, but I think that ND and Iowa State would be my picks to make sure that they didn't lose in that matchup, even though, you know, I do like your low point spread, you know,
theory
mention. It's a good point.
Yeah. And Shake and Bake, want to add anything there? What about Vermont? I love Vermont.
I love Vermont. I love mid-major teams who are medium seeded. So you're 9 to 13 range. Who are coming in on win streaks and score efficiently. Because there's a certain point in this time of year where offense really takes over playing defense. Louisville is one of the few exceptions where Louisville pretty much every year, but except for their national title year in 2013, Louisville is always a team that's a serious threat simply because they play defense, turn the ball over, and get easy buckets. After that, if you're a mid-major team with a little bit of size who can, you know, hit drain from deep easy or just play good efficient offense, I'm probably taking you in an upset. Just because a lot of these big boy teams from these big boy conferences look over them. Look at last year. An example is West Virginia, who basically lost to their own system who was that? Was that South Dakota State?
Stephen F. Austin.
The Lumberjacks.
Lumberjacks
with
Stephen
my
Stephen F. Austin. Yeah.
Stone cold Stephen F. Austin.
Yeah, exactly. I love that. A team that could hit from three but played the same defensive system as West Virginia did because they have a Huggins disciple as their coach, and they made it all the way to the Sweet 16 and just tore people apart. A couple years ago, North Dakota State was the same way. Just had a good big guy, could drain from three. Northern Iowa with Ali Farouk-Manesh
one of my favorite tourney moments.
Ali Farouk-Manesh and the 7'3" center Jordan Eggleseder, who could drain from three as well.
With the tattoo.
Yeah.
So, leprechaun tattoo.
Teams like that tend to have tournament success. And that's like the little bit of research you have to do. Because if you start digging into who's better, Villanova or Duke, based on the numbers, you're probably going to drive yourself insane because they're probably going to look pretty similar.
Yep, exactly.
They do.
So, exactly. Well, guys, without boring too many more people with our genius insights, let's dive into the first round. Now, we're not going to actually bore you with every single tournament pick this week. Schmoes, we're going to go week by week, see how we do, and the predictions are going to come round by round. So we're going to do the first round and the round of 32 heading into the Sweet 16. We're going to leave it there and then give you a little preview into our Final Four national title pick and see who's the dumbass of the group by the time we get there.
Yeah, I'll probably be the dumbass of the group.
I mean, I hate my bracket. I always hate my bracket. I hate it all. I hate it.
I like it before.
Yeah, but I hate it before, and then I sometimes end up liking it, or I just want to light it on fire. It's really, really just a shithole, as you mentioned.
I've had a perfect bracket 3 out of the last 4 years.
Oh, have you now?
I have, yeah. It's been a good run.
Wow.
How come you don't have a billion for Warren Buffett, then?
I forgot to sign up all 3 of the years.
It was
a shame.
Sounds like you got a really good eraser pen there.
It's an oversight.
All right, well, guys, let's dive in at the top. Let's start left to right. Let's start with Villanova and who's that? Mount St. Mary's. 1-16.
They
beat the New Orleans Privateers. Sadly.
They did.
I wanted to see the
another great, another very important insight. Do not confuse St. Mary's and Mount St. Mary's.
They're both in the tournament.
Yes, they are both in the tournament. Easily confusable. And also, the 16 in front of Mount St. Mary's does not mean they're up 16-1 already.
No.
I've made that mistake before. So I don't think we're going to see a 16. This is not the year.
It's not the year.
How drunk were you?
What?
How drunk were you?
I don't do any.
When you made that mistake.
I don't do any of my sports gambling ventures drunk. Except for betting the Cleveland Indians.
You did do that. We heard about that one.
Right.
All right. Well, let's keep in the Rain Man. I assume that you're picking Villanova. Something just tells me that you are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I have no 16 upsets.
Okay. Wow.
Good man, Rain Man. Have you picked one, Rain Man?
No. It's not going to happen. Like, the 2-15 has become a lot more poignant in the past couple of years, especially Duke Lehigh. But
Duke Lehigh.
The 1-16 just wouldn't happen. CJ McCollum, man.
CJ McCollum. Kyle O'Quinn.
Kyle O'Quinn. I was trying to think of the Knicks center who isn't good in the NBA but was great at Norfolk State.
Over Mizzou.
Yeah. Well, speaking of 2-15, Duke Troy. Is Duke getting knocked out?
Not again.
Dancing on. Let's all be real here. Let's be smart. Troy. Let's make good decisions, guys.
I didn't even know Troy had a basketball team. Yeah, I thought they were only a football team.
I did is because they weren't that far away from my college.
Right.
Baylor, New Mexico State, Devok's favorite team, Baylor.
Oh God, Baylor's fucked so many people over in the past.
Like me more than once. I've been suckered in too many times.
I actually watched the New Mexico State Cal State Bakersfield WAC final.
Nice.
Due to, you know, pure degeneration. New Mexico State. New Mexico State's not going to be there. They're not going to beat anybody.
No, I don't think so either. I'm picking Baylor. You know, when you have a guy like Jonathan Motley, like New Mexico State is one of those teams who doesn't have an efficient offense and a big guy who can help you out. And when you have a guy like Jonathan Motley, you're hoping, knock on wood, that a guy like Jonathan Motley and Baylor's athleticism can actually help them win a game for the first time for frickin' ever.
Did they win last year? When's the last time they won a game?
I don't even know.
Last year they lost to Yale, and then the year before that they lost to
Georgia State.
Yeah.
Yep.
They'll get over the hump.
Get over the hump.
Yeah.
Where are we? We're moving on to the 4-seed, Florida versus East Tennessee State.
Florida.
A lot of people like Eastern Tennessee. I'm not going to get sucked into it. No. I have Florida, but a lot of people like East Tennessee.
Don't be as surprised as you think. I only take schools in Tennessee that are in the middle.
Fair. That's a little precursor.
It's a little too far east.
Virginia and UNC Wilmington.
I'm going to say UNC Wilmington.
Yeah. People are hot on UNC Wilmington. Have they ever won a tournament?
They are.
They've won a tournament game. I know they almost beat Maryland one year. Way back. I don't think they've ever won a tournament game. I know nothing about them other than that they're the Seahawks.
They are the Seahawks.
I think the biggest thing is that Virginia is a slow-paced team, and that allows for a lot more variance. And I think that UNC Wilmington has a good enough offense to get through it. And I think that Virginia is going to have to really convert on everything. Game close, and I don't know if they will. I think they're not. They don't look as hot as they have in years past. And
I think they're
primed for an upset.
See, I like UNC Wilmington too. I like the seniors. They do have tournament experience, even though they got bounced last year. I like them more than I like Virginia. Virginia has no one on offense besides London Parentes, as far as I'm concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And if they still had a Malcolm Brogdon kind of guy, it'd be different, but they don't. I just don't like Virginia this year. I didn't like them all year.
I know someone who follows college basketball pretty closely, and he's taking Wilmington as well, citing that Virginia kind of sucks. I will say I could definitely see an upset here. I'm going to take Virginia, though.
Okay.
That's fine.
I mean, you're an asshole, but that's fine.
Yeah.
SMU versus the play-ins.
I already went into that.
You like SC? You like SC to win versus SMU?
Yes, SC over SMU, absolutely.
I'm taking SMU.
I'm sticking with SMU.
You have a adult beverage and something else on me.
All right, let's do it.
We'll leave the something else up to our viewers. So where are we? All seven. Right, something seven. Else. South Carolina.
I can think of a lot of things. Marquette. I had no idea what to do with this game. I take Marquette because I can't remember South Carolina.
Take Marquette. South Carolina is not good.
Okay.
I think they're underrated. As an SEC alum who just watched their alma mater beat them in the SEC tournament and outlast them in a 4 overtime slugfest, Sindarius Thornwell, the SEC player of the year, is great. The rest of the team is nothing special. Take Marquette, take the tournament experience.
I also am taking Marquette, but it is good to note that Marquette's strength is their 3-point shooting and South Carolina's strength is their 3-point defense.
That's true too.
It is going to be a really, strength versus strength to see who goes through. But I do think Marquette's going to prevail.
Give me an experience.
Is Frank Martin still a coach in South Carolina?
Yeah.
He is. Mm-hmm. That's great.
He does have some tournament experience, but this team as a whole does not. And they haven't played well in the last two postseasons when they've had real chances to be in the tournament. And this was the first year they actually made it in. Last year they were ranked all year and didn't make it in because they blew it in the tournament and had a bunch of bad losses.
Yep.
I legitimately have not. I haven't even thought about Frank Martin in the past, like.
It's because no one thinks about South Carolina basketball.
Yeah.
Everyone's still really focused on whether Jadeveon Clowney is playing for the football team.
Right. Really, since Gus Johnson and Kansas State and Xavier, that game.
Yeah.
The Jordan Crawford game.
That's fair.
That's fair. The ultimate Gus-gasm, by the way.
God, I love Jordan Crawford. What a great
game. Oh, man.
Yeah, all right, let's wrap it up. Right. Let's wrap up the East region, Wisconsin or Virginia Tech?
Wisconsin, they're 5-point favorites. I'll take Wisconsin.
I got Wisco.
Hokies.
Hokies, all right.
Hokies. I've watched Wisconsin. I've found a way, even though I really dislike Wisconsin, to watch like every bad Wisconsin basketball game this like as they've, you know, stumbled into the Big Ten tournament, get all the way to the finals, and they just had no answer for a team like Michigan. Virginia Tech beat Michigan earlier in the year. Is another explosive offensive team under Buzz Williams. Give me the Hokies. Those stupid Hokies.
All right.
Let's move west. Zags. Mm-hmm. Zags versus the Jackrabbits of South Dakota State. Zags.
Watch. That's actually a pretty decent 16 seed.
That's really not a bad 16 seed. But yeah.
It's not. But I'm not going to risk it on this. on this one.
But Zags.
If it was North Dakota State, I might take the plunge. I'm a big North Dakota State Bison.
That's fair.
Bison guy. But South Dakota State, I'll take Gonzaga.
All right, Zaga. No. Arizona versus North Dakota. Not the Bison, just North Dakota.
We really skipped the Bison here.
The Fighting Hawks. We're talking about
the Fighting Hawks.
Fighting Hawks basketball, man.
Formerly known as the Fighting Sioux.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, because they made them change their nickname.
Everyone's racist, so it's fine.
Here's the time to throw in my 32-1 bet on Arizona at the beginning of the year to win the national championship. Thank you. Shout out to Schmo.
Yeah. Fearless leader.
Shout out to Schmo for the little tip. So I got to stick with Arizona, right?
Yeah. Hey, if it's your money, man.
It is. Yeah. Bill Walton would want me to stick.
Bill Walton would want. God, I wish he was calling games during this. Holy crap!
You wish. He was getting a little bit too much.
I mean, he's insane. He's absolutely clinically insane. But that's for another Schmo tape.
He's also stoned to the bone.
He's like, clinically insane and on a lot of drugs. Many drugs. Florida State versus Dunk City, FGCU, Florida Gulf Coast, baby.
Yeah, Florida State.
Florida State, I'm going with Florida Gulf Coast because F it.
Okay. That will be awesome.
I just like their ability to get to the hoop. I like their ability to play easy offense. And Florida State is one of those teams who offense doesn't come easy for them, but they have enough defense and athleticism to match up with anyone. So this is a risky pick, but I'm going to take it because F it. And, you know.
Risky is not even the word.
I know.
Florida State has a guy named Dwayne Bacon.
Dwayne Bacon is excellent. I have no doubt about Dwayne Bacon.
He's good. And Florida State's like 14.5-point favorites. This is quite the bold prediction here.
Why not?
Yeah.
Why not?
That's crazy.
There's no money in this one.
not in the Schmo table bracket, the three-person Schmo table bracket.
Exactly. All right. Keep moving on. West Virginia versus the Bucknell Bison. Different Bison.
Bucknell has had some tourney success.
They have.
Mike Muscala.
They beat Kansas. That
Atlanta's native son.
Bucknell's heavy dogs here. They're 13
heavy.
13.5 points, I think it was.
Yep. Yeah.
West Virginia, they got upset last year. I think we'll rebound this year.
Yeah. I'm doing the same reason as I think a lot of these – West Virginia kids have come back, and Bob Huggins isn't going to forget. And I've grown up knowing a lot about Bob Huggins' temper, so he's not going to let that happen 2 years in a row.
There you go. Yeah.
Or he will legitimately have another heart attack, and
We don't want him to have a heart attack.
Yeah, Bob Huggins is too much fun to, you know, let him crap right now on the court.
I pick West Virginia too.
Yeah. Just defense. Yeah. They find ways to make easy offense. They play great defense. Turn the ball over.
Their press is great.
Yes. Notre Dame Princeton. We talked about the Ivy League, so here it is, guys.
Oh yeah, we talked about
this. Are you putting the Princeton offense in over the Irish?
Yeah. Why not?
No.
Why not?
I'm picking Notre Dame.
You gotta be loyal to your Ivy League brethren. Rain Man.
Yeah, Rain Man. I expected more from you. Not from me though. I'm picking Notre Dame. I already made my bold prediction on this one.
Benedict Rain Man.
Benedict Rain Man. I didn't go to Princeton. I went to Cornell.
They're the same.
Ivy Leagues are the same.
They're your brethren. We know all you guys are douchebags. You can't trick us.
You know, honestly, GQ rated Cornell as the douchiest college in America. I can't even argue with that.
Yeah, my brother's a big douchebag.
There you go.
All right, fine. You know what? I'll just do Princeton just because. All right,
guilt trip. We're going to keep them. We successfully guilt tripped them.
I'll take Princeton.
Maryland Xavier. Let's keep moving.
Maryland to Xavier doesn't have their best player, and I don't want to pick them.
I'm picking Xavier
as well. It's not a Cincinnati thing. I've also watched Maryland choke away so many tournament games.
Yep.
I just can't de-pick them again.
Yep.
Yeah.
So
don't blame you.
St. Mary's VCU.
St. Mary's.
Not Mount St. Mary's. I also have St. Mary's. I just think they're a better team. VCU is a good team, and I think this will be a close game. But I've got the Gales.
The Gales.
Big on the Gales. All right. There are two Gales
in this tournament.
There
two
are
two Gamecocks and two Gales.
That's a rarity. All right, Divock. Right. Let's see how Chicago you really are. Northwestern versus Vanderbilt. Battle of the Nerds.
You have to be on. Like, I can't even imagine how much acid you have to be on to pick Vanderbilt to win a tournament game.
Even
Northwestern, who's never won a tournament game in the history of their –
They've never been to one. They've never been to one.
I will be taking Northwestern with flying colors because Vanderbilt, you'd have to – you could literally –
What's the spread on this game? Do you have any idea?
Vanderbilt's giving 1.5, but Vanderbilt doesn't win tournament games.
They do not. That's true, too.
Not only that, Northwestern's playing with a chip on his shoulder. Like, they're coming in hot. I mean, they've never been to the tournament ever. You don't think they're coming in with some chip on their shoulder? Really?
Northwestern will take this one. Vanderbilt.
I picked Northwestern. Yeah. That's fine. I'm just seeing what I can get out of you guys. Cool.
These are very smart schools, Vanderbilt and Northwestern.
They are. Intelligent group of people, but Vanderbilt still can't figure out a formula to get past the first fucking round.
Nope.
Let's move to the Midwest, our neck of the woods, boys and girls. Kansas versus a play-in 16 seed.
Well, it depends who wins, right? I'll take Kansas.
I think we're all going to take Kansas. Rain Man, are you? Unless you got bold on us, please don't be bold on us.
I'm not being bold.
Louisville versus the other Gamecocks, the Jacksonville State Gamecocks, not from Florida.
I will not pick a little crappy
town in Alabama.
Right, I won't pick Jacksonville State because Jacksonville's not a state. These guys aren't imposters. They're gonna lie to America and think we're gonna pick them.
Not over Patino in the tournament.
No, not over anybody.
My favorite state school, Joe Dumars alum.
McNeese State.
How is that a state school?
Why are all these states? Why is
Morehead State every 25-year-old's favorite college?
I picked them when they beat Louisville. That is Kenneth Faried, baby.
I did too. Yep. I picked Kenneth Faried just so I could write Morehead once in my tournament bracket. Just like whenever Oral Roberts is in, I pick Oral Roberts. To write Oral. And that school's
all about butt sex.
All about it. Lots of lube.
Oral Roberts.
Oregon versus Iona.
Even without Boucher, I have Oregon.
15-point favorites. I'll take Oregon.
Yeah, there's no way I'm not picking Oregon. Even without Boucher, I like Oregon a lot. Period.
So only room for one Gale in the second round. Yeah.
I just don't even know how to respond to that. Purdue versus Vermont.
Catamounts.
Purdue's another
consistently disappointing tournament team.
Yeah, I learned that the hard way again last year after learning that the hard way again years before.
I know they are, but I'm taking Swanigan and Purdue.
The nation's longest winning streak, I believe it's 21 games, belongs to the Vermont Catamounts.
Vermont Catamounts.
I still think Purdue will win. I think Purdue will come through. No, they have a solid
big man. I'd rather take the risk. I would rather take which CBS has the Catamounts with a 10.8% chance to win. They don't have a spread here, which is really annoying. So I'm going to rely on you there.
That's nine and it's jumped to 9.5 now.
Oh, so give me the Catamounts if it's under 10.
So they're right there with East Tennessee State, who are also 9.5 right now. But
give me Catamounts. Iowa State, Nevada.
Iowa State. Yeah, they don't have Hoiberg anymore.
They're hot.
No more. They're hot. No more Hoiberg.
Love Monte Morris. My favorite future backup point guard in the NBA. Creighton versus Rhode Island.
Everyone's taking Rhode Island here. Everyone's taking Rhode Island, I feel like.
Yeah, and I'm one of everyone.
Yep. I'm taking Creighton.
Okay, that's fair. Also, term experience team, that's fair.
I'm taking Creighton, too. I think that they just have experience, and I like that. But Rhode Island is a hot pick.
Yeah, I don't like the Rams. Hot pick.
Give me the Rams. I'm big on the Rams.
Is Jeff Fisher their coach?
Hmm?
Is Jeff Fisher their coach? The Rams?
No. SDSU didn't make it, unfortunately. Michigan versus Oklahoma State.
Michigan.
Yeah, Wolverines are hot.
Is that Oklahoma State any good? I don't even know. I know Oklahoma State's 1-9 versus the top 25 this year.
Then they are not good, you could say.
They're not.
0-6 in the Big 12, or started 0-6 in the Big 12 and finished 9-9. But
they have a really hot offense.
And they're on a 3-game tournament losing streak.
Yeah, I'm going to pick Michigan regardless. But,
Devon, I think you're right. Before we got into picks, Michigan is hot and has tournament experience. Derek Walton was on that Elite Eight team with Stauskas and Jordan Morgan. And Derek Walton is playing like a player of the year candidate that he's not going to win, but that's okay.
Yeah.
I'll do Michigan.
Yeah. Give me the Wolverines. All right. Wolverine. Where are we now? The Hurricanes Miami versus Sparty.
Here's what I know. Every time people count on Michigan State, they show up and they make a run.
They do.
Last year, everybody wanted to take them, and they blew it to Middle Tennessee. This year, I'm taking them over Miami. I'm taking them.
I'm taking Sparty.
Yep.
Brain Man?
I'm also taking Sparty as just a tournament coach, and they have to rebound from last year. They have to.
I mean, they don't, but, I think they're going to.
No, I mean,
Miami's not a bad team either. Miami has some tournament experience, but it's Larrañaga versus Izzo is not an argument.
Yeah, I mean, Larrañaga had that miracle run with George Mason.
But it's still not.
It's Izzo. Izzo's the man.
Still not an argument. All right, moving on. South region, Dirty South. North Carolina playing Texas Southern. Who you got? Mm-hmm.
Mike Davis. Trivia question. Alma mater, Texas Southern. Hall of Fame NFL player. Who was it?
Is that Strahan?
Good job, Shake and Bake. Very good.
Yeah.
Way to go,
Shake. I can't remember if he was Grambling or Southern, but I knew he was one of them that
Texas Southern
is on CBS once a year. I'm not
good
going Strahan now. I'm going for Roy Williams.
Good. Yeah, we'll do that.
Yeah. All right.
The ceiling is the roof. Remember that.
Yes, exactly. And it will remain the roof as long as Michael Glenn says it is.
Yep.
Kentucky versus the Northern Kentucky Norse. Guys from right across the river. I can see their campus anytime I'm in downtown Cincinnati.
In-state rivalry.
But I'm just not even coming close to picking Northern Kentucky.
No.
Kentucky is also hot.
Kentucky's also hot.
And they're Kentucky.
And they pay their players. I take any team that pays their players over teams that don't.
That's also
They're pretty also much a professional squad.
Yeah. Calipari could, legitimately, Calipari got Marcus Camby to come to UMass. I mean, think about that.
You know,
he got a Final Four.
He should be in the Hall of Fame for that. Like, what the type of money he had to dish over to Marcus Camby to make him come to play basketball?
Hey, man.
At UMass.
Calipari does it the right way. His problem is he got caught changing grades at Memphis, which was his own fault. You let boosters do that. You let just talk to Saban, talk to Urban Meyer, talk to Pete Carroll back in the day. You let the boosters take care of that. You keep your hands off of it.
But he was probably panicked because, like, Derrick Rose, like, he had to, like, change Derrick Rose's grades probably.
And Robert Dozier.
Robert Dozier.
Derrick Rose basically failed the ACT and, like, then aced it. And he was supposed to go to Florida. Billy Donovan's like, are you kidding me? Hell no. And then John Calipari's like, welcome to Memphis. Doesn't matter. Yeah.
That's
called good coaching. Yeah. All right. Number 3 UCLA versus 14 Kent State.
It's not an Antonio Gates reprisal. I pick UCLA.
Give me the $1 billion shoe deal. Give me Lonzo.
Who's LeVar Ball picking?
I couldn't imagine. We might have to talk about LeVar Ball at another time here. That guy needs to shut the hell up.
LeVar Ball.
2.2 points at Washington State, and he could beat Michael Jordan in one-on-one.
Okay, all right.
UCLA, go.
Butler, Winthrop.
Butler.
All Butler.
Winthrop is Loosthrop.
Even without Brad Stevens, Butler.
That was fucking terrible. Moving on. Minnesota, Middle Tennessee. Are we all taking Middle Tennessee? Are we taking Tennessee in the middle of Rock?
Oh, you got to take a 12 seed that's favored. Have to.
You got it.
Yeah.
Got it. CBS is really blown. They have Minnesota as a 56% chance to win. No thanks.
No thanks, CBS.
I love everything about, like, I watched Middle Tennessee State's tournament. I watched them a couple other times this year. That team's just fun to watch, period. Good. Not to mention they just beat up on Sparty last year.
Blue Raiders, do it.
Yeah. All right. Bearcats versus K-State or Wake Forest. Do we have a final in that game yet?
K-State won.
Yeah, K-State's up by 10. Seven with 36.5 seconds left.
I think we're good to go.
So Kansas State is winning.
Kansas State's going to win.
You're taking Kansas State over the Bearcats?
No. Cincinnati. I won't take Bruce Weber. You kidding me?
Okay. That's fair.
I also will not take Bruce Weber, so I'll take Cincinnati.
Well, that will just sadly make three of us. Well, that was almost a fun upset pick. Dayton versus Wichita State. This is going to be a great game. I'm low key. This might be one of the games I'm most excited about in the first round.
Agreed.
Wichita State's a 6-point favorite.
I'm picking Wichita.
Yeah, Wichita all day. Got to go with the 6-point favorite. That's 10 seed.
They just have tons of experience. Oh, you're doing Dayton Flyers, huh? Are you?
I just really want to take Dayton real bad.
For the purposes of devil's
advocacy, I'm going to take it. I'm going to take Dayton. I'm going to go to Glasgow's. I'm going to watch it there with all these Ohio people who I've never met before.
Ohio bias.
Yeah.
I don't like the rest of the state of Ohio. Like,
Ohio bias.
Either way. I mean, yeah, I'm kind of a toss-up here, but I'm going to go with Dayton for the sake of devil's advocacy. Arkansas, Seton Hall.
The maintenance guy at my gym, he said to watch out for Seton Hall. That's what he said the day of when they almost beat Villanova. So I'm riding with Pierre. Shout out to Pierre, maintenance guy. He said, watch out for Seton Hall. I'm going to watch out for him. I'm taking Seton Hall.
I'm also taking Seton Hall.
Who's the head coach of the Razorbacks?
Nolan Richardson.
My mind is so. Who did Mike Anderson lose to the last time he was a higher rated seed in the tournament?
I'm going to say Seton Hall.
Norfolk State when he was at Missouri.
Oh, Norfolk State.
I'm going all Seton Hall.
Seton Hall.
All Seton Hall. All Pirates. Big fan of Pirates. Always liked the Pirates.
That's why I was upset the New Orleans Privateers lost.
They would have won if they were Pirates.
Yeah, but I mean, Privateers are just like – Pirates that are condoned.
No, not as good. He's a privateer.
Well, privateers are those like the, yeah,
he's legit.
Have you seen
Pirates of the Caribbean? The only legitimate history of piracy. Like, come on.
Yeah.
Privateers are totally sanctioned by the government. They are not just
They sound like skanky pirates.
The French did it. The French were the
main you're digging yourself in a deep hole by bringing up the French. Okay.
I know. That's I'm tanking myself, honestly, in this one because they're not technically pirates. You know what? My bad. I just like the idea of some. You know, I've been watching Black Sails a lot recently, and I really like anything pirates. All right. You know what?
Okay. Oh, sorry. Rain Man's done talking. Okay, so back to guys, let's go to the second round, round of 32. Let's dig back in to the Eastern bracket. You guys have Wisco versus Villanova. I have Villanova versus Virginia Tech. Are we all going Nova?
Yes.
Ben and champs move on. All right. I have did we all pick UNC Wilmington? Remind me. Or no, D-Buck, you pick Virginia.
Yeah.
All right. So do you have Virginia or Florida?
I have Virginia moving on.
D-Vock, do you have Wilmington or Florida?
Rain Man, but Florida.
Florida.
Oh, did I say D-Vock? My B. I meant Rain Man. Sorry, you put me in sleep earlier, so I really just wanted to talk to you, Vec. I have UNC advancing to the Sweet 16.
Bold.
Yeah, bold. Taking it. I like it. I like the senior league.
You know they're not UNC. You know they're not the same as UNC, right?
I know. The disappointing Texas battle, or D-Vock's favorite game of the tournament, SMU or Baylor?
No, I got SMU. Okay, I got USC.
Oh, yeah, so you have USC. Excuse me.
I have USC.
Which means you're taking USC.
Oh, yeah. USC, when they beat Providence.
Well, then Rain Man and I are both going with SMU, so Rain Man, we're back on good terms. Okay.
Chill.
Marquette, do we all have Marquette versus Duke?
Wait, could we send over how many more rape allegations are going to come out against Baylor before their term again? I feel like every day, new allegations come out against Baylor. Oh, man.
It's been bad recently. It's been bad.
I feel like every day something new comes out about that.
And then the women's basketball coach says punch him in the face. Like, it just doesn't get.
Yeah, that's fine. It's a quality athletic program they're running at Baylor. Isn't Baylor like technically? Christian school too, or some denomination of Christianity.
Yes, very Christian.
Yeah,
great.
I mean, it's almost made you forget that literally, like, not that long ago, one of their own players killed another one of their players. You know that?
That's true. And then the coach tried to hide it up.
Yep. Stellar place Waco is. So we're all picking Duke. Is that what you guys are telling me?
No, I'm not picking Duke.
You're picking Marquette to beat Duke.
Oh no, I'm picking Duke over Marquette. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. You go Marquette, and you're picking USC to beat Baylor.
Yes.
We're all picking Baylor to lose, is basically what's going on, because they're doing enough losing as is. Fun. All right.
Yeah.
So, in our Sweet 16, we have Villanova, Florida, Virginia, and UNC Wilmington. So, just that's going to be fun for whoever actually gets that right.
Yeah.
Luckily for us, it's probably going to be Eastern Tennessee State.
We're all missing both.
We have some SMU and some USC, USC, and we have Duke. Fun. Great.
Good times.
West. Good times. Gonzaga versus Northwestern. Is the magic count staying on?
It ends here. We go with the Zags.
Zags.
I watched the video of Adam Morrison crying on the floor.
I saw it today too. It was great.
Great stuff. One of my favorite all-time videos. This is going to
be a young Darren Collison led UCLA team.
And Luke Richard Bamute. Listening to Gus announce that one with
who is the ugly asshole who is the center that Kevin Love took over for on that UCLA team?
Lorenzo Madureal. Is that who it was?
That might be. God, he was hideous.
Yep.
He was one of the ugliest people to ever play sports.
Yeah, he was. Him and
just hard to look at.
Him and like Josh Boone.
Yeah. Oh, that's another good one.
Sam Cassell.
Well.
Sam Cassell is from Mars. That's a confirmed fact.
That's a given.
All right. So Zaga moving on to the Sweet 16. I have West Virginia versus Notre Dame. I believe you two have Princeton versus West Virginia. Who do you guys have advancing, Princeton or the Mountaineers?
We'll take the Mountaineers.
I'll take the Mountaineers. I had Notre Dame beating West Virginia, but because you guys pressured me to Princeton, I'm doing West Virginia.
That's what we're here to do. Peer pressure is the first pressure. Friendship. I also have West Virginia. I have Florida Gulf Coast because I'm a bold little asshole, and you guys have Florida State.
You do. And that's not a good pick,
both by the way. Divock, you have Maryland. So Maryland or Florida State?
Florida State.
Florida State?
Yeah.
Rain Man, Xavier, or Florida State?
I have Xavier.
I have Xavier as well. Okay.
Wow. What is Xavier?
Xavier is an experienced team. You're right. They are missing their best player. You're not wrong about that. But I like the potential for them to make it to the Sweet 16. St. Mary's or Arizona?
Arizona.
So Zaga, yep. West Virginia, Florida State / Xavier, and Zona onto the Sweet 16.
All right. Sounds good to me. I think that's about exactly. Yeah, sounds good to me. Except for that little Xavier.
Well, that's fine. You can have what you want. Yeah. Kansas versus Michigan State. Divock, I believe you have a fun pick here.
Michigan State.
Taking
Why not? Fuck it. I'm taking Michigan State. Throw numbers out the window when it comes to Michigan State. There's every year those picks, you're like, who ended up in the Final Four, you see them on top of your bracket, you say, oh, how could that person pick that team? And you know, Michigan State, no one's going to pick them this year. I'm going to pick them last year. I'll do it. Michigan State over Kansas. You know, you go big or you go home, especially when you're in a bracket with like a bajillion people. So why not? Do it. I foresee that. Yep, let's do it.
Wow. All right. It's locked in. It's Michigan State. I mean, I have Kansas. I'm going with Kansas. I know that, Divock, I'm going to text you when these two teams play in the second round. Yep. And I'm going to feel like such an asshole because I had the opportunity. You're telling me right to my face, basically, that I should take Michigan State, and I should, for all the reasons that you described. Mm-hmm. But I'm just going with Kansas because I'm just kind of a pussy.
That's fair. It's fair. But I'll be in Vegas,
That's how it is.
I'm doing the same thing. I'm taking Kansas.
Well, that's not surprising. But anyway, Iowa State versus Vermont or Purdue, if you're Rain Man.
Iowa State, yeah.
Iowa State, like I said, Vermont's riding that huge win streak, but I love what Iowa State's doing right now. They're also a team who came back from like 19 or 20 points down to beat Kansas at home and Kansas's home win streak, and they've been on fire since then. So yeah, I like Iowa State. Yeah. I have Rhode Island. Do you guys both have Creighton? Remind me.
Creighton, yes. Creighton.
Yeah, I have Creighton.
Creighton, so, okay. One of those guys are Oregon.
Oregon. Even without Boucher.
Oregon.
Oregon, yep. Okay, cool. So we're all with Oregon in the Sweet 16. Fun. Michigan or Louisville, which I also think will be a really fun game to watch with a little revenge factor in it for the Wolverines.
I'm all aboard the Michigan train.
Me too. Wolverines all the way.
I have the Wolverines. I think I'm going to regret it, but I have the Wolverines. They are hot. Louisville. Wow.
A threefer.
I think Beeline remembers the mistakes he made against Louisville in the national title, and this team is built better to beat Louisville now than they were in that national title game.
Revenge game. Do it.
Revenge game. I like it. I like revenge. Who doesn't like revenge? Come on. We're all in our 20s. We love revenge.
Yeah, good show. Everyone's
humble at this age. Shit. Mm-hmm. North Carolina versus Seton Hall. We all have the Tar Heels.
Yeah.
Besides Pierre. Pierre has Seton Hall.
Pierre,
the maintenance guy.
I wouldn't sleep on the upset, but I'm definitely taking North Carolina here. Just same thing. Term experience, yada, yada, yada.
I have a strict policy of only listening to maintenance guys in the first round.
That's fair.
Yeah. So North Carolina.
Tar Heels?
Yeah, Tar Heels.
Tar Heels. All right, Middle Tennessee State versus Butler. Do we all have the Blue Raiders? Are we all going to have fun here and be the Blue Raiders?
No, Butler. Because Butler? I don't pick against Butler.
There are three teams
I always take to the Final Four. I always take Michigan State, I always take Butler, and I always take UConn. And this year will be no different. And I don't care that UConn's not in it. I'm still taking
UConn. Oh, that's so fair.
I'm taking UConn to the Final Four.
It's so fair, Welcome. but I'm gonna I'm gonna be. I want Middle Tennessee to win.
I know what you want. I don't care what you want.
I'm just gonna pick them.
I mean, I'm picking Butler. I would love to pick Middle Tennessee State, but I'm picking Butler.
It takes every ounce of my being not to go analytical here, but I'm really just going to try and let this one go and just say no.
I mean, I don't think there's anything wrong with picking Middle Tennessee State. That's a fun pick to have, but I think D-Vox right. Just Butler plays in the tournament. Doesn't matter who's their coach. Doesn't matter who's on the team. They play well in the tournament.
It's true.
Yep.
Sure. Cincinnati versus the Bruins of UCLA. LeVar Ball, Bruins.
Bruins.
I have Bruins.
So much offense. Yeah. So much more offense than UC could possibly ever muster.
Yep. Yeah.
I have Dayton. You guys have Wichita versus Kentucky. Are we all Kentucky?
Yeah.
Kentucky. Well, yep.
That locks it up for now.
Yep.
So, guys, let's move on to a little preview. Just because, so that we have something to look back on and make fun of each other for, or just be like, wow, we are all really bad at sports. Who do you guys have in your final four when it's all said and done?
I have Kentucky. I have Michigan State. I have, yeah, you heard me.
I know.
I have Kentucky, Michigan State, Arizona, and Villanova.
Okay.
I have Duke, Arizona, Michigan, and North Carolina.
Michigan.
Okay. I have Duke, Arizona, rematch of the first national title game I remember watching, and then I have Kansas and UCLA.
Okay.
Now, I'm going with the LeVar Bruins. Do not tell me who you have winning both games. Okay. Tell me who is your national champion, and that's it. No final score, no matchup, one team name. D-Vock.
John Calipari's.
Okay. Rain Man.
UNC.
UNC. I have the Wildcats of Arizona.
Okay. All right, there it is. I hope you're right, Rayman. I mean, I hope you're right.
You definitely hope I'm right.
I hope I'm right. I know how my future bets end up, though. They end up in heartbreak, always.
Oh, well, sorry, man.
Always.
I mean.
My Royals-Mets World Series bet? Oh, boy.
It's okay. Okay.
Oh, boy.
I
Mets, 25-1 on the Mets. 25-1. The Royals.
Well, man. Guys, that wraps it up for the first – first two rounds of the NCAA tournament. Kick it off on Thursday. D-Vock, when do you go to Vegas?
Hold on. I go to Vegas on Thursday, but we never got into Syracuse.
You have to
never got into Syracuse because what really grinds my gears, I was Dickie V was bitching about it on ESPN, and Boeheim was on there looking all sad in his Boeheim face. And said, oh, they looked at our losses only. You know what? Fuck that. Okay? Wouldn't have lost to St. John's by 33 points and been 2-11 on the road, the committee would have just thrown you in there without even a thought. But you guys lost to all these Boston College and Georgetown and UConn and all these garbage teams, and you expect to show up there and get in, and you know what? No bubble team deserves to be in, and no bubble team deserves
God,
to
the
be
bubble
in.
Was so bad this year.
It's bad. I mean, would I have complained if USC was out and Syracuse was in? Of course not, but you can't gripe about it because it's your own doing that you're on the bubble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Win more games.
I thought it was funny that during when was it? I can't remember if it was during the Kentucky SEC championship game or afterwards. Because you're right, Dickie V did complain about it, and then he went back another time and was like, "Oh well, Syracuse Boeheim. And Boeheim. Thank you, Boeheim and Syracuse. You know, they didn't win the big games away from home, baby. Like they're not getting in the tournament. You got to win the big games. You need your PTP, which stands for." Prime time player. That wasn't my best Dick Vitale impression, but it was close enough.
Well, it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad.
But yeah, it's one of those things where they literally just didn't win big games this year, and that's just how it is. And
I mean, they won that game against Duke.
Yeah, and that honestly, that's like it.
And they beat Florida State by 10.
Cool.
But in the end, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter whether they won the big games, they lost the big games. The fact is, they lost so many games. There was 14 games, so if you didn't lose 14 games, if you lost 10 games, the committee wouldn't even have to make this decision.
Yeah.
Right. So, well, they also lost to North Carolina by 17 and Notre Dame by 18. I mean, those are major losses. You know,
you lost to St. John's by 33. I mean, they're going to take that into account next year. That's how bad that loss was. Yeah.
I mean,
33 points to St. John's.
Yeah. I mean, my mom, they
couldn't win away from Syracuse. Their away record was just absolutely atrocious this year.
Yeah, 2-11.
Atrocious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Terrible.
Terrible.
Have we all seen the steaks on a plane commercial while we're on the subject of terrible?
No.
Oh my God. The Capital One, Samuel Jackson, Charles Barkley, and Spike. They're not Spike Lee.
Spike Lee.
The steaks on a plane joke commercial.
We'll see it, I'm sure, a ton during the tournament.
At least even now, it is so worth your time. Schmoes everywhere. It's so worth your time if you haven't already seen it, which you probably have because it was on repeat this weekend. And I haven't rolled on the floor laughing at a stupid ad about nothing that I'm going to ever partake in, which is generally a Capital One credit card. Yeah. And since the Zeusk Mountaintop commercial, also worth a YouTube if you don't know what that is.
All right, I'll take a look at it, Shake and Bake.
You will not regret it, sir.
We'll talk about it next time.
Yeah, we will. Great. Yeah. We'll talk about it in the Sweet 16, boys.
Sweet 16 when I have my perfect bracket going.
Oh, yes, of course.
And by the way, anyone out there thinking of trying to fill out the bracket in chalk on the sidewalk in front of your house, I've done that before. My bracket got busted when it rained. It was very, very disheartening.
Of course,
in Chicago, there's about 2 inches of snow on the ground, so maybe next year.
Next year, maybe.
Maybe next year.
Everyone's saying chalk, chalk, chalk. I tried to do it, and it didn't work out. So.
Tisk, tisk, tisk.
Tisk, tisk.
All right.
There goes my joke. Peace.
Peace.